And you're looking for an apple sandwich.
Oh my goodness, they're fighting and I'm not gonna sleep all night. Oh my goodness, oh my goodness. She was born on October 28th. We will be back to get her soon.
We looped half of a silver cloth around her neck and kept the other half. So that when we come back for her, you will know that she's our baby.
Oh my goodness, they're laughing.
All right, do you want to go to sleep with your teeth inside your mouth or out?
Really gone. I know. Somewhere. Somewhere.
and lock you in the cellar again.
I don't care. I'm getting out of here. Okay, go now.
Good luck.
So long, Dumbbell. Good luck.
Ha! I caught you, Brat. I fear you. I always fear you. Get out. I said, get out.
Yep, stand again.
There. Now, what do you say? What do you say?
I love you, Miss Hannigan.
Run, orphan.
I am not an orphan. My mother and father left it out saying they never loved me and they were coming back for me.
That was 1922. This is 1933. They must have got stuck in traffic. You here, get out, get out, get out. Put them things away. Now, for this one's shenanigans, you'll scrub this floor and strip them beds for the laundry.
What
a
boring.
I know. And you'll get down on your knobby little knees and clean this dump until it shines like the top of the Chrysler Building.
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Get to work. Now, why any kid would want to be an orphan, I'll never know.
It's a hard knock life for us. It's a hard knock life for us. We get tricked. We get kicked. It's a hard knock life. And the folks who speak of so, it's a hard knock road we have.
Oh, hi, Aggie. I'm running late.
I'll see you in January.
Aw, come here, you handsome brute. Don't you want to know what I'm getting you for Christmas?
What?
Egg Foo Young in Chinatown for two on me.
Egg Foo Young for Christmas?
All you can eat. So what are you getting me?
What did I get you last year?
Nothing.
You'll get the same thing this year.
Get out of here with that laundry.
Alright, well, Merry Christmas, Aggie.
Yeah, Merry Christmas.
And Merry Christmas, kids.
Merry Christmas, bundles.
Are the herald angels singing, da 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 da.
You call this place clean, Annie? This place is a pigsty. Annie? Annie? Where's that Annie?
Annie ain't here.
What do you mean, Annie ain't here?
What we are today. homework are you doing?
Tristan's not out here.
Wait a minute, guys. You can't break character. Continue with the scene. Call for him. That's what a normal person would do.
Drink. Good afternoon. Drake, everyone?
Miss?
Has Mr. Warbucks arrived yet?
No, miss, but his plane landed at 3:30, so we're expecting him any minute.
Do you really live here? Or is this a train station?
We really live here.
Oh, boy!
May I take your coat, miss?
Will I get it back?
Of course, dear.
Gee, I really love this coat, Carol.
I'm glad, dear. Now, what would you like to do first?
The floor. I'll scrub them. Then I'll do the windows.
No, dear, you won't have to do anything while you're here.
I won't?
No, of course not. You're a guest, and for the next 2 weeks, you're going to have a swell time. Now,
Cecilia will pick out all your
greatest dress color, dark blue, I think.
You'll set this trap like Mrs. Greer.
Oh,
and then comes in to make your bed.
Has the painting from Paris arrived?
Yes, sir. They're just about to hang it now, sir.
Oh, yes. No, I don't think so. Grace?
Yes, sir.
Messenger?
Yes, sir. President Roosevelt, he wants you to call him at the White House.
I'll get back to him tomorrow. Anyone else?
John D. Rockefeller, Mahatma Gandhi, and Herb Bummer.
Nothing urgent. What did Herb Bummer want?
He didn't say.
Wait a minute. Maybe I could learn to live with this thing. Hang it someplace.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Rollins, I'd like you to meet the orphan.
Oh, and Mrs. Pugh. Wonderful.
I know potatoes.
Wonderful.
And bacon.
I won't be having dinner tonight. I'm afraid I have too much paperwork to get through.
Wonderful.
Grace, I'll need you for dictation, please.
Yes, sir.
All right. Good to see you all again.
Sir.
Drake? Dismiss the staff.
Yes, sir.
Grace, if you get your notebook in, who is that?
This is Annie, Mr. Robbins, the orphan who will be staying with us for the Christmas holidays.
The orphan? But that's not a boy. Orphans are boys.
I'm sorry, sir. You just said orphan, so I chose a girl.
Oh. Well, I suppose she'll have to do. Annie, huh? Annie what?
Sir?
What's your last name, child?
Oh, I'm Mr. Warbucks.
I haven't gotten a last name. That I know.
So you're just Annie?
Just Ann.
I don't suppose you'd like to meet Babe Ruth.
Oh, boy, sure.
Who's Babe Ruth?
I couldn't be happier that you'll be spending Christmas with us. Grace, we'll start with the figures on the iron ore shipments from Toledo to... What are we supposed to do with this child?
It's her first night here, sir.
Oh, it is. Well, Annie, your first night here, I guess we ought to do something special for you.
A movie!
Would you like to go to a movie?
Oh, boy, sure. I've heard a lot of that, but I've never been to one.
Never?
No, sir.
Well, then we've got to do something about that right away. You'll go to the Roxy, then an ice cream soda at Rumpelmayer's, and then a handsome cab ride around Central Park.
Golly!
Grace, forget about dictation for tonight. We'll do it first thing in the morning.
Yes, sir.
Instead, you take Annie to the movies.
Yes, sir.
Aw, Jane.
Something the matter, Annie?
Nothing, sir. It's just... Aw,
Jane. Well, what is it? You don't want to go to the Roxy?
No, I want to.
Me? Oh, no. I'll be far too busy.
Oh, gee.
You see, Annie, I've just been away making an inspection tour of my factories, or what's left of my factories with this darn depression. Anyway, when a man is running a multi-billion-dollar corporation that has...
Excuse me, sir. Bernard Baruch calling.
Good. Hello, Barney. Yes, I got in an hour ago. No, Detroit, Chicago. Barney, I didn't like what I saw up there. Factory shut down. My factory shut down. You're dark too, but I'm not making money. Nobody is. And gosh darn it, Barney, your pal Roosevelt, he's got to do something. He's got to do something drastic. He's got to come up with a new plan, a new approach, a new something. Yes, I know he's a Democrat, but he's a human being, too. Yes, I'll talk to you about it. Come over here tomorrow night. Good. We'll be able to... I can show you the... parties. Make it tomorrow night. Tonight, I've got to go on a date to the movies with a 10-year-old girl.
11.
I was mistaken. She's 11. Bye, Barney. Drake?
Yes, sir.
Coates?
Yes, sir.
Grace, you'll come too, of course.
Yes, sir.
Will you be watching the Bentley or the Duesenberg, sir?
The Duesenberg.
Excellent choice.
No. Wait. This child's been cooped up in an orphanage. No Duesenberg. Well, what?
Walk to the Roxy?
Sure, why not? It's only 45 blocks.
Yes, sir.
Oh, smell that. Marvelous. Fifth Avenue bus fumes. There's no air like the air of New York. And you don't realize how much you miss it. The whole darn city until you've been away from it for a while. Like the man says, after New York, every place else is Gerard. And... YC, what is it about you? You're big, you're loud, you're tough. And YC, I go years without you, that I can't get enough. Enough of cab drivers answering that in language far from pure. Enough of freight forwarders answering that. Brother, you know you're in NYC. Too busy, too crazy. Too hot, too cold, too late. I'm so again, YC.
Hey, you, little girl. Come here.
Yes, officer?
That dog there. Ain't I seen him running around the neighborhood? Ain't he a stray?
A stray? Oh, no, officer. He's my dog.
Your dog, huh? So what's his name?
His name is Sandy. That's right, Sandy. Well, Sandy, you see, because of his nice sandy color.
Sandy, huh? Well, let me hear him answer to his name.
Answer? You mean what I call him?
Yeah, when you call him by his name, Sandy.
You see, sir, I just got him.
Call him. License, you understand? Or he goes straight to the pound and they put him to sleep.
Yes, sir. I understand. On a leash and with license.
All right, well, get out of here before you catch your death of cold in this weather.
Oh, I don't mind the weather.
Here. I can't stay back. We'll get him, sorry.
All right, that's all the fresh air you get for the month.
For herself what so many women long to prove, that because a woman is 35 or more, romance and life need not be over, that romance can live at 35 and after.
Oh, merciful God, I hope so. Yeah?
Miss Hannigan, is it?
Yeah?
I'm Lieutenant Ward from the 17th Precinct. We found your runaway. You.
Thank you so much, officer. Children, guess what?
What?
There's hot cocoa and ginger snaps for you in the recreation room.
What recreation room?
Get out of here! Thanks so much, officer.
Here, we found her down by one of those Hoovervilles, down by the docks. Had a mean G-mutt with her, but he got away.
Aw, oh, poor pumpkin out in the freezing cold with just that thin sweater. I hope you didn't catch influenza. Thanks so much, officer.
All in the line of duty. And you, I don't want to ever hear you run away from this nice lady ever again.
But she heard.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, officer. You, I'm going to have your head for this, and next time you walk out that door, it's going to be 1953. Well, you glad to be back? Lie! What's the one thing I always taught you? Never tell a lie. Well, what's the one thing I always taught you?
Never tell a lie, Miss Hannigan.
What you got, I'd be fired. Have the Board of Orphans sticking their nose in here. Well, you'll pay for it, I promise. Stay.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Yeah?
Oh, good. I'm Grace Farrell.
So?
And the New York City Board of Orphans suggested that.
Hold it! I can explain everything. It was Annie who see? Who jumped in the bundle's laundry bag and...
Miss Hannigan, I...
And I know I should have called Mr. Donatelli at the Board of Orphans instead of the police, but I...
Miss Hannigan, I'm sorry, but I haven't the slightest idea what you're talking about.
Hold it. If it's beauty products you're peddling, I don't need any. Get out.
Miss Hannigan, I am not peddling anything. I'm private secretary to Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks?
The Oliver Warbucks.
Love the coats! I've read Winchell's column that Oliver Warbucks is the richest unmarried man.
I don't know. I don't read Mr. Winchell. Miss Hannigan, Mr. Warbucks has decided to let an orphan spend the holidays at his home.
An orphan? You sure you much wouldn't rather have a lady? I got 2 weeks coming. It's a joke. What kind of orphan do you want?
Well, she should be friendly and intelligent.
Mississippi,
capital
M-I, double S-I, double
S-I-double-P-I. Oh, and cheerful. Shut up! And how old?
Oh, age doesn't really matter. Say 8 or 9. 10, 11. Yes, 11 would be perfect. And I almost forgot to mention, Mr. Orbus prefers redheaded children.
11? Redhead? Sorry, we don't have any orphans like that around here.
But what about this child?
Annie? You wouldn't want her. She's a drunk and a liar. A drunk and a liar.
Yes, I'm sure she's a drunk and a liar. Annie, would you like to spend the next 2 weeks at Mr. Orbus's home?
Oh, boy, I would love to. I would really love to.
Hold it. Now you can have any orphanage, but not Annie.
Well, why not?
I just told you.
I assume, Miss Hannigan, that this has something to do with all the business about the laundry bag and the police. Perhaps I should call Mr. Donatelli at the Board of Orphans and sign it.
I'll sign it. I'm an easy guy to get along with. If it's Annie you want, it's Annie you'll get.
It's Annie I want.
It's Annie you'll get.
So if you'll get her coat, we'll be right along.
Coat? She ain't got no.
Then we'll buy her one.
Oh, I'm getting a coat.
She's getting a coat.
Come on, dear. Mr. Warbucks' limousine is waiting outside.
Hey, kids, I'm getting out of here for Christmas. All right, dear?
Bye, Annie.
Bye, kids.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan. And season's greetings.
Yeah, season's greetings.
And now, CBS Radio brings you Ma Perkins. Ma's daughter, Faye, is going to marry Carl Michaels. On Friday, Carl went back to Chicago.
Oh, Carl, don't go back to Chicago.
But no sooner had Carl left town than Dr. Andrew...
Yeah?
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Oh, yeah, Farrell. Only 1 week. Warbucks fed up with Annie already?
No, on the contrary. Mr. Warbucks is delighted with Annie, and Annie's having the time of her life.
How nice.
Yes, she and Mr. Warbucks are practically inseparable. They go everywhere together, to the Roxy, to the Stock Exchange, and guess where they had lunch yesterday?
The Waldorf?
The Automat.
The Automat.
And she just loves her new coat. She never takes it off.
Never?
Miss Hannigan, I know you're busy, but these have to be signed and sent back to Mr. Donatelli by no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow morning.
What for?
Because Mr. Warbucks is to be taken with Annie, that guess what?
What?
He wants to adopt her.
Oh my, how wonderful. Now let me get this wonderful news straight. Annie's going to be Warbucks' kid, the daughter of a millionaire?
Oh, no, no, no. The daughter of a billionaire.
A billionaire? My, my, my. My, would you excuse me for a moment? Got any more wonderful news?
I told you about the coat, didn't I?
Oh, you told me about the coat.
Then good day, Miss Hannigan, and Merry Christmas.
Yeah, Merry Christmas!
Oops, pardon me, Blondie. Hi, sis, long time no see.
Rooster, oh God, never rains, but it pours. They finally let you out of Sing Sing?
I got 6 months off for good behavior.
I'll bet. What was it this time?
Some old geezer from Yonkers said I swindled him out of $1,100.
Oh yeah? Why would he say that?
Because the rooster swindled them out of $1,100.
Aw, Lil.
It's true.
Sis, I'd like you to meet a friend of mine from...
Jersey City.
Jersey City, Miss Lily St. Regis.
I'm named after the hotel.
Which floor?
Don't you just love Lily, sis?
Yeah, I'm crazy about her. Rooster, do me a favor.
Anything.
Get out of here and take the St. Regis with you.
Aw, come on, sis.
Can it! Looking for another handout, huh?
Nah, I got $80 coming in the mail Thursday. So all I need is 10 to tide me over.
Not even a nickel for the subway, Rooster.
A fiver, Aggie?
Huh, I got left. $5? Oh, God, you with all your big talk gonna be living in clover.
This ain't exactly Buckingham Palace.
Oh, yeah, I'm on the city. Steady salary, free food, free gas and electric. I'm doing all right.
Sis, you doing like I'm doing.
Lousy.
Aw, Abby, how do you Hannigan kids ever end up like this? On the skids. I remember the way our sainted mother would sit and croon us her lullaby.
Say, kids, there's a place that's like no other. You gotta get there before you die.
You don't get there by playing from the rule book.
You stack the aces.
You load the dice.
Mother dear, oh, we know you're down there listening. How can we follow your sweet advice?
Sprout for $3 or $4 while she gets Warbucks.
The little brat.
It ain't fair, this here life is driving me nuts. While we get peanuts, she's living fat. Maybe she holds the key, that little lady, to getting more bucks instead of less. Maybe we fix the game with something shady.
Where does that put us?
Oh, cellar.
Give you one guess.
Yes!
And now, CBS Radio brings you Ma Perkins. Ma's daughter, Faye, is going to marry Carl Michaels. On Friday, Carl went back to Chicago.
Oh, Carl, don't go back to Chicago.
But no sooner had Carl left town than Dr. Andrew...
Yeah?
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Oh, yeah, Farrell. Only 1 week. Warbucks fed up with Annie already?
No, on the contrary. Mr. Warbucks is delighted with Annie, and Annie's having the time of her life.
How nice.
Yes, she and Mr. Warbucks are practically inseparable. They go everywhere together, to the Roxy, to the Stock Exchange, and guess where they had lunch yesterday?
The Waldorf?
The Automat.
The Automat.
And she just loves her new coat. She never takes it off.
Never?
Miss Hannigan, I know you're busy, but these have to be signed and sent back to Mr. Donatelli by no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow morning.
What for?
Because Mr. Warbucks is to be taken with Annie, that guess what?
What?
He wants to adopt her.
Oh my, how? Now let me get this wonderful news straight. Annie's going to be Warbucks' kid, the daughter of a millionaire?
Oh no, no, no. The daughter of a billionaire.
A billionaire? My, would you excuse me for a moment? Got any more wonderful news?
I told you about the coat, didn't I?
Oh, you told me about the coat.
Then good day, Miss Hannigan, and Merry Christmas.
Yeah, Merry Christmas!
Oops, pardon me, Blondie. Hiya, sis, long time no see.
Rooster, oh God, never rains, but it pours. They finally let you out of Sing Sing?
I got 6 months off for good behavior.
I'll bet. What was it this time?
Some old geezer from Yonkers said I swindled him out of $1,100.
Oh yeah? Why would he say that?
Because the rooster sold them out of $1,100.
Aw, Lil.
It's true.
Sis, I'd like you to meet a friend of mine from...
Jersey City.
Jersey City, Miss Lily St. Regis.
I'm named after the hotel.
Which floor?
Don't you just love Lily, sis?
Yeah, I'm crazy about her. Rooster, do me a favor.
Anything.
Get out of here and take the St. Regis with you.
Aw, come on, sis.
Can it! Looking for another handout, huh?
Nah, I got $80 coming in the mail Thursday. So all I need is 10 to tide me over.
Not even a nickel for the subway, Rooster.
A fiver, Aggie?
Huh, I got a laugh. $5? Oh, God, you with all your big talk gonna be living in clover.
This ain't exactly Buckingham Palace.
Oh, yeah, I'm on the city. Steady salary, free food, free gas and electric. I'm doing all right.
Sis, you don't like I'm doing.
Lousy.
Aw, Aggie, how do you Hannigan kids ever end up like this? On the skids. I remember the way our sainted mother would sit and croon us her lullaby.
She'd say, kids, there's a place that's like no other. You gotta get there before you die.
You don't get there by playing from the rule book.
You stack the aces,
you load the dice.
Mother dear, oh, we know you're down there listening. How can we follow your sweet advice?
Easy street,
Mr. President. I'll grant you that Barney Baruch and I are not exactly standing on bread lines, yet, no, I'm not asking for your help. I've never asked for any man's help, and I never will. But I'm telling you, you've got to do something and do it fast. All right, we'll talk about it on
Friday.
All right, Friday, the lighthouse. Goodbye, Mr. Listen, Mr. President, why don't we bury the hatchet? You come over here with Mrs. Roosevelt for supper Christmas Eve on your way to Hyde Park. Good. I'm delighted. Goodbye, Mr. President. If I thought he was going to say yes, I never would have asked him. Call L. Smith and find out what Democrats eat.
Yes, sir.
The package from Tiffany's.
Yes, sir. It arrived this morning.
Fun. I'm going to give this thing to her, and then I'm going to tell her that I want to adopt her. Where is Anna?
She's in her room, sir, writing another letter to her friends at the orphanage. I'll have Drake call her.
Fine. Thorne?
You don't have to be nervous, sir. She's going to be the happiest little girl in the world.
Darn right she is. I'm not nervous. Get her down here.
Yes, sir.
Hello, Annie. How are you today?
Fine. How are you?
Fine.
Hi.
Hi. Annie, the time has come for the two of us to have a very serious discussion.
You're sending back to the orphanage, aren't you?
Annie, can we have a man-to-man talk?
Sure.
Why don't you sit down?
Okay.
I was born into a very poor family in Hell's Kitchen, right here in New York. By the time I was 10, both my parents had died. I made a promise to myself that someday, somewhere, one way or another, I was going to be rich, very rich.
That was a good idea.
By the time I was 23, I'd made my first million. Within 10 years, I turned that into 100 million. Boy, in those days, that was a lot of money. Anyway, making money is all I've really given a darn about. And I might as well tell you, Annie, I was ruthless to those I had to climb over to get to the top. Because I've always believed one thing. You didn't have to be nice to the people you met on the way up if you didn't plan on coming back down again. You understand what I'm trying to say?
Sure.
Good.
Kind of.
Kind of?
Not really.
Darn. I was in Tiffany's yesterday, and I picked this thing up for you.
Oh, gee, thanks.
I had it engraved.
Oh, gee.
It's a silver locket. I noticed that old broken one you're always wearing. And I said to myself, I'm going to get that kid a nice new locket.
You really don't
have to. Here, we'll just take this old one off. And
no, please, don't make me take my locket off.
Annie, what is it?
My mother and father. They left this with me when I left me at the orphanage. They're coming back for me. I know that being here for Christmas with you, I'm lucky, but one thing I want in all the world is to be like kids, with folks of my own.
Annie, it'll be all right. I'll find them for you. I'll find your parents for you.
Shh, baby.
I'll get her a brandy.
Miss Annie, if you just see, I'm able to find your parents. Mr. Warbucks is the man.
He'll pull every political string there is to pull, up to and including the White House.
The League of Nations.
If he should be FBI, then he will have the FBI.
With all the favors that he's done. J. Edgar Hoover owes him one.
request Gina. A day, a week, months, for however long it takes. Go to a vacation, I'll pay for it. I'll pay all costs. When can I have it? Tomorrow. Oh, and Jay, I want Elliot Ness. I'll just take him off the Capone case.
Thank you, Annie. On America's favorite radio program, The Oxygen Hours of Smiles, starring your old softie, Bert Healy. A moment is yours. Say something.
Thank you, Bert Healy.
But still, remember, folks.
Smile, darn your smile.
Right, Wacky. Smile, darn your smile. Say, Wacky, who was that who just walked into our WEAF studio? Now, all of our Warbucks, I understand that you have something to tell the folks at home about our little Annie here.
Yes, Bert Healy. Annie is an 11-year-old foundling who was left by her parents on the steps of New York's Municipal Orphanage on the night of December 31st, 1922.
And aren't you now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents?
Yes, Bert Healy, I am now conducting a coast-to-coast search for Annie's parents. Drop page. Furthermore, I'm offering a certified check for $50,000 to any persons who can prove they are Annie's parents.
Wow!
So Annie's parents, if you're listening in, write to this station, care of New York WEAF Studios, or to Oliver Warbucks
at my home, Bert Healy. At my home, Bert Healy, 987 Fifth Avenue, New York, New York.
That's 987 Fifth Avenue, New York, New York.
And I would also like to take this opportunity to thank the makers of all new Oxident toothpaste with Miracle L64 to fight bad breath for letting me appear here this evening. Drop page. And did I just do a commercial? Bryce, I've never endorsed a product in my life. This is absolutely ridiculous.
Thank you, Oliver Warbucks. Good night, Oliver Warbucks. So, Annie's parents, if you're listening in, there's $50,000 and a wonderful daughter waiting for you. So get in touch right away to hear.
Hey, Mr. Healy, is it time to get
for a lovely boy that's just this? It most certainly is, Wacky. Well, I see that another of your thirsty night get-togethers has gone by faster than you can say Oxident.
Oh, O-X-Y-D-E-N-T.
The toothpaste of the stars.
To make your teeth Hollywood bright.
So for all the hours of smiles, family, Ronnie, Bonnie, Connie, Fred McCracken, this is Bert Healy saying, hey, hobo man, hey, dapper dan, you both got your style, but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile. Your clothes may be bow gruffly, they stand out a mile, but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile. Boylan sisters.
It's gonna be all right, Cheryl. She's gonna be here, and she's gonna be ours again. Ma'am?
What do you want?
Well, we had terrible troubles back then. We had to leave a baby here on the front stoop.
Our little girl, our Annie.
Annie? Your Annie's parents?
Please, nothing happened to her.
I can't believe this. Annie's parents. Where'd you say you come from again?
We come from a little farm up in Canada.
Manitoba.
Here we got lots of chickens.
Little chickens.
And ducks.
Ducks.
And geese.
Oh, you should see all the geese.
And roosters. Gotcha, sis.
Oh, God, rooster, I never would have guessed those you in 100 years.
Fooled you, Abby, and we're going to fool Warbucks, too.
Get ourselves 50,000 whip ones.
50,000? This is gonna be the best bunco job ever, Aggie. I know a guy in jail who can knock up a faith birth certificate or any other papers you need. But we need your help, sis, for details about Annie that can help us pull this thing off.
Yeah, I can help you. A lot. But what's in it for me, Ralph?
Three-way split, Aggie.
Half, half, half.
Straight down the middle. But we gotta do it fast. Give us something old Rooster as a bachelor. In and out. 2-3 minutes at the most. Get the money, get the kid, and get out of town.
Yeah, the kid. Annie. That's the problem. What are we gonna do with her afterward?
Oh, Aggie, that's no problem.
When Rooster wants something to disappear, it disappears.
For good!
Rooster!
Aw, come on, Aggie. We get the money, we blow this crummy town, and then little me, we'll meet ya.
Where? Oh, yeah.
Campaign promises. All we have had from Franklin Delano Roosevelt and his so-called brain trust is a great deal of high-flown talk and virtually no action. In a nation racked by poverty, misery, and unemployment, it is deeds we want from the White House, not words. In short, Mr. President, if you are listening, we've had enough of your fireside chats. It's time to
criticism. Nothing but criticism.
I know.
It's awful. Did anybody see the Washington Post this morning?
My friends, I say again, the only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
Franklin, you've already been elected.
Every cloud has a silver lining. You're never fully dressed without a smile.
Yeah.
Oliver Warbucks and crying, Franklin. Thank you, Louie. Show them in. Oliver? Oliver. Good of you to have come.
Good morning, Mr. President.
Well, who is this we have here?
Mr. President, this is my good friend, Annie.
Annie?
Well, she so wanted to meet you, I couldn't resist bringing her along. Just to say hello.
Of course.
Annie, this is President Roosevelt.
How do you do, President?
How do you do, Annie? You're as lovely as you sounded on the radio.
Thank you, President.
Well, shall we begin?
Annie, if you'll wait outside, I'll...
No, Oliver. Let Annie stay. Having a child on hand will keep us all on our best behavior.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Harold, I don't want to hear so much as a gosh out of you.
Franklin, a child?
Well, Oliver, since you speak for those happy few Americans who have any money left, I'd like to begin with your views on matters.
Well, Mr. President, in the words of Calvin Coolidge, the business of this country is business. And for the good of you, this country, Wall Street, and me, we have to get my factories back open and workers back to work.
Well, according to my latest figures, there's now 15 million Americans out of work, and there's nearly 50 million with no visible means of support.
Mr. President, if I may say so, unemployment is not our worst problem. The dispatches from Germany have become more and more disturbing every day. There could be a war.
Germany, people are starving in this country.
Harold, I know that, but in the long run, we're not.
Cordell, for people who are starving, there is no long run.
The trouble is, it's happening all at once. The stock market has taken another nosedive.
Sit-down strikes, riots,
floods, dust storms.
And the FBI still hasn't caught Al Capone. Well, at least we're all agreed on one thing. The situation's hopeless and getting worse.
Morgenthau, I'd like to see those pictures.
to 617 women who have claimed to be Annie's mother, and 619 men that said they were her father. That makes, let me see,
1,236.
They're all liars, Drake. I never realized there were so many dishonest people on the island of Manhattan.
Some are from the Bronx, Miss.
Grace, we're back!
Where are they, Miss Vale? Where are the people?
They're gone, dear. Come and gone. I'm sorry, but they were all liars and fakes, after nothing but $50,000.
Are you certain?
Yes, sir. None of them knew about the locket.
They just came by a special messenger from the FBI, sir.
Oh, finally. Elliot Ness has located the manufacturer of Annie's locket in Utica, New York.
Oh, boy!
That sort of locket was manufactured between 1918 and 1924.
Sort of locket?
Yes. Over 90,000 were made and sold.
90,000?
Annie, I'm afraid that the gist of it is Ness doesn't think there's a chance in a million of tracing your parents back to this locket. I'm sorry.
That's okay. I mean, we did the best we could. You can't find them. Nobody can.
Excuse
me. I guess a kid can get along without books. It didn't turn out so bad. He got everything. All his decent birds hanging on the wall and everything.
Annie, a Duesenberg's a car. Babe Ruth is the right fielder for the New York Yankees. There's something else you should know. Not bad for an old man, huh?
Drake!
Call Justice Brandeis and have him come over to sign those adoption papers.
Yes, sir.
Grace?
Yes, sir.
Tell Mrs. Pugh we'll have a house full of guests. We'll need flowers.
Flowers.
Caviar.
Caviar.
Champagne.
Champagne.
Excuse me, sir. Everyone is getting, and these are your words, sir, spiffed up for the party.
Oh, good. Maybe Annie and I should get spiffed up, too.
Come on, Annie. We'll take you upstairs and put you on one of your new dresses, and Annette can do your hair for you.
Yes, take her upstairs and get her spiffed up.
Don't need anything but you.
Sir?
What?
Sir?
Excuse us, folks. We don't mean to interrupt. Surely, look, there's our Annie.
Who are you? Honey, we're your mom and dad.
Mudge. Mudge's name, Ralph Mudge. And this here's wife, Shirley.
Honey, you never do it, dear, but you're Annie Mudge.
Annie Mudge.
We was sick and broke, honey, and didn't know which way to turn. And a mate gave us a chance to work up on his farm in Canada.
But we couldn't bring along no baby.
We love you, Annie, but we had to leave you behind.
Sir Mudge, we've seen a great number of people who claim to be.
Proof? I expect you'll be wanting proof of who we are. Here's our driver's licenses and Annie's birth certificate.
Baby girl named Ann Elizabeth Mudge, born to Ralph and Shirley Mudge. New York, New York, October 28th.
October 28th? That's my birthday.
It was in her notes, sir.
Yes, I know, but I still don't.
Mister, please, you gotta believe us. We got in on the Greyhound this afternoon and went straight to the orphanage to fetch our Annie. And the lady there said our baby was up here.
Oh, Annie, all these years I've dreamed of holding you in my arms again.
Mr. Mudge, on the night that Annie was left at the orphanage...
Oh, here's something you wouldn't know about. When we left Annie at the orphanage, we left half silver locket with her. We kept the other half, so it was one day.
Oh, Ralph, look, she's wearing it.
And here's the other half. Yes, it fits perfectly.
Oh, thank God, Ralph, she's our Annie.
She is, she is.
She seems to be.
Well, if you'll be getting Amy's things together, we'll be taking her along.
Take her?
No.
Just a minute, Mr. Mudge. What about the money?
Money? Well, we ain't got much, but we'd be glad to give you...
You haven't heard that I've offered a certified check for $50,000 for anyone who can prove they were Annie's parents.
No, sir. We don't know nothing about no check. Anyway, we don't want no money.
Right. We don't want no money for Annie.
On the other hand, Cheryl... Remember that little pig farm out in New Jersey? With $50,000, we could buy it. We could afford to bring any bread in the country. Fresh air, fresh eggs, fresh ham. Certified, huh? All I gotta do is make it out to myself.
That's correct. Tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning?
You wouldn't mind if I kept Annie till tomorrow morning. Christmas. Then you'd come back tomorrow and pick up Annie and the check. Problem?
No, whatever you prefer, sir. So, I think we should be getting back to our hotel now. Goodbye, Annie. Until tomorrow morning, honey. And then you'll be spending the rest of your life with us.
Goodbye, Annie. Dear.
Oops. Pardon me, Blondie.
Merry Christmas, y'all.
Season's greetings, one and all.
Well, this is wonderful news.
Yes. Wonderful.
And he's found his parents. And they seem to be very nice people.
Nice.
You're lucky, Annie.
Right, I'm lucky. Just think, a big fun.
We must celebrate. Because it's Christmas Eve. And we've just had the most wonderful news in the world. Annie has found her mother and father.
Annie.
Lost Annie.
Mr. Mudge, I think I've seen him someplace before. I just can't remember where or when.
Mr. President.
No, Franklin.
Franklin, I need your help.
Oliver, whatever I can do for you.
That's it.
Looking at them, it's easy to climb.
Thank you, Grace. I could never have... Oh, Merry Christmas, Annie.
Merry Christmas, Annie.
Merry Christmas, Mr. Warbucks, the Sparrow.
You're up early.
Well, my folks are coming for me, so I guess I just wait here for them, because they're taking me out of the country. You'll come and see me sometimes.
Of course, Annie, I'll come see you.
You're up early, too.
Oh, we've been up all night, dear, and we've had quite a time of it. FBI men coming and going. Annie, did you know that President Roosevelt was here?
Really? Merry Christmas, President Roosevelt.
Merry Christmas, Annie. It's good to see you again.
Good to see you too, President Roosevelt.
Franklin.
Annie, early this morning, FBI Director Hoover telephoned me with some very sad news. Through the paper and the handwriting on your note, he was able to trace the identity of your parents.
Yes, we already know that, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
No, Annie, they're not your parents. Your parents are David and Margaret Bennett.
David and Margaret Bennett? Where are they?
Annie.
Annie, your mother and father passed away a long time ago.
You mean they're dead?
Yes, dear.
Are you all right, Annie?
Yes. So I guess I always knew that my folks were dead, and I knew that they loved me, and they would come for me if they weren't.
I love you, Annie Bennett.
I love you, too. Now, who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
Atta girl. Who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
The birth certificate could have easily been forged, but the thing is, they knew about the locket.
Yes, the locket. That's your key.
We're the only ones who knew about the locket. And the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
Miss Hannigan, sir, and the children from the orphanage.
Oh, Miss Hannigan, I'm delighted to meet you.
Same here, and I know you anywhere. You're the Oliver Warbucks, right?
Yes. Allow me to introduce you to my staff, Miss Hannigan. You know Miss Farrell, my secretary, of course.
Yeah.
And this is the President of the United States.
Sure.
And this is my butler, Drake.
Excuse me, sir. They just came by a special messenger from the FBI.
Oh, good. Comes the dawn. Now it all fits together.
Annie, come look at this.
Leaping lizards! Who would have guessed?
Show it to the president.
Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
Show them in, Frank.
With pleasure, sir.
Franklin, would you like me to have them call for your car?
No, no. Eleanor can wait.
Won't you please come in, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge?
Good morning.
Good morning.
And Merry Christmas, one and all.
Merry Christmas.
Merry.
Thank you, Drake.
Christmas.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad.
Hello, dear.
Well, we don't want to bother you at all on Christmas. We've just come to pick up Annie. Oh, and her bag.
Allow me.
Oh, and the check.
Oh, yes, the check. I had almost forgotten. Here it is, Mr. Mudge. $50,000. Certified.
Pay to the order of Ralph Mudge.
Read it again.
Pay to the order of... The jig is up.
The jig is up, Daniel Francis Hannigan, also known as...
Rooster Hannigan, Ralph Mudge, and Danny the Dip.
Bye, Mom. Bye, Dad.
Franklin, I do believe that fraud is a federal offense, and your Secret Service men have the power to arrest.
Yes, they certainly do. Drake, will you turn them over?
Yes, sir.
Solo for Warbucks. And to
find this woman's their accomplice. Ba la 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 la, la 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 la. Arrest her too!
Me? I haven't seen these people till yesterday!
Aw, come off it, Aggie.
Yeah, sis, if little me is taking a fall, so are you.
Oliver, our bucks, tell them how nice I...
Miss Hannigan, the jig is up.
Eddie, tell them how good nice I always was to you.
I'm sorry, Miss Hannigan. Remember the one thing you always taught me? Never tell a lie.
I'll let you in on a secret. I never liked you, and I never liked any of you, either.
Annie, we'd sure love to meet your friends.
Okay. Kids, this is Miss Grace Farrell.
Hi, kids.
Hello.
And this is Mr. Daddy Warbucks.
Hi, kids.
Hello.
Oh, and that's the President of the United States.
Hi, kids.
Hello.
Kids, this Hannigan is gone for good.
Hooray!
And you won't have to work anymore.
Hooray!
Instead, you'll have classrooms and teachers.
Aww. Well, listen, kids. Now, fire, fish.
Hooray!
Yes, girls, for you and perhaps for all of us, this Christmas is going to be the beginning of a wonderful new life. I know the depression's depressing.
The candles still, the stores are not clear.
And windows are minus the dressing.
Children don't spring, the Santa's a thing.
And I've heard a terrible rumor, no goodwill, no cheer. But we'll get a new deal for Christmas this year.
The snowflakes are bright and they're falling, and the wolf picks no peppermint sticks.
And all through the land, boats are calling.
Cummings!